Oh my goodness, this is the new camera here, this photo booth one, and that's yeah. So, back to the discussion this morning of the motives of keep, the motives of keep. Yeah, I don't have a great relationship. Like, hey, I'll call my aunts on the telephone, whatever, and say hi, how are you? Because they're all participants in the motives of keep. Now, the motives of keep are often precipitants of fear. Keeping the children, keeping the children close by, keeping the children near, based upon the precipitants of fear, worry. I have to have them nearby me. As a, I don't know. It's something that's been going on for years and years and years. It's nothing new predicament in my family specifically. I've even seen in my former husband's life, his mother and granny. You know, they'd share their washing machine. You know, even you know, the washing machine would be at one house and the dryer in the other. And they had to have this, you know, this kind of predicament of keep, you know, have to. And it would be unheard of and unheard of for her, you know, to move to another region of the world, you know, an unheard of, unfathomable, you know. So in that predicament, it's almost like the child becomes the ex-child, the black sheep, so black, so dark that, yeah. My gosh, you know, it doesn't really matter who you are, it doesn't matter who you are at all. The strength is in that general have to keep the child near the parent, no matter how old the child is, you know, grown adult, you know. Keep them near. Some people say it's a control. I guess so. We'll go and say it's a control unit. We can't escape from. It's a control unit we cannot escape from in certain predicaments. And our only escape has been up to this point in time is huge amounts of gains of making money, as our escape mechanism. You know, move away. You know, not play the 50. What they call it? Like in Italy, it's like the 50 miles. You're only allowed 50 miles distance away from your mama. yeah, that type of a deal. Yeah, it has to be really, really tight, and close, you know, tight closeness. Or else, you end up being kind of a I don't know. It's like loyalty is lost. It's like loyalty is lost with you. It's a different type of a harbinger against you know, harbinger event. Yeah, because you have become a traitor. Yeah, it's a sad deal. It's a sad deal, the predicament of keep. So anyway, well, I guess so. I guess it's for nobody to know me. In self, it's only the keeper and what the keeper tells.